I'm Tim Grievous with Phillips Entertainment Lighting, Dallas, Texas. I'm lead test engineer. We're at LDI at 2016, and we're in a special meeting room that has been named our new technology showcase. This room, the function was to be able to demonstrate some new products that we were going to release, prototypes and so forth, but also we want to keep it entertaining. So the concept of an immersive environment that involved several bits of technology, which includes special video clips, audio sounds that have a spacey feel to them, and a controlled environment with controlled seating. We are able to have the customer in a specific position, and we can actually target the lighting to have its optimum angle of incidence for the presentation. This presentation is about 6 minutes long. During this process, we do talk about the products, the new products, their features and so forth, but we also, at the end, we end in a rock and roll finale. Doing these types of shows takes a special expertise because it's not just a creative thing. You have a function to be technically accurate and also hit the points that are necessary for the marketing and sales group and have the correct message and also make it entertaining. Recently with Phillips Entertainment Products, we have began to start focusing on the size of the exiting aperture of the fixture. In the 4K's beam wash, we have a rather large exiting aperture, and we feel that this size of an exiting aperture is really interesting to the audience. Instead of seeing a little dot with a big light coming out of it, now you're seeing a larger source, and it adds character and interest to the rig. Besides just the lighting portion of it, it looks good. This kind of the technology that we're doing in our menu systems now, we're able to do things from the console. We can send a command of status, and all of the displays will either show a red if there's any errors or green. And you can do this from the console 350 feet away in house, front of house, and you can see if any of them have an error or not. This kind of menu functionality gives us the ability to do things without having to go touch the fixture. We're working on things that are really important, such as RDM, extending the functions in RDM so that we can use a laptop. Instead of having to have a console, the technician can have the laptop and he can send these commands via to the menu system to do these functions, recals and so forth, from backstage, and be able to do it quickly without having to haul a console and so forth like that. I think we're focusing on bright fixtures that actually are very light in weight. They look heavy because of the way that their style is, but they're surprisingly lighter than you would expect. There's some amazing technology that we've been doing with LED arrays, engines, and we're able to get some 5600 Kelvin color temperature and a brightness that is equivalent to arc lamps in their class. It's very impressive. The field is flat. It doesn't have a hot spot. Back to the veteran portion of what my function is I've been using lighting on tours and doing a lot of programming in the industry. And this insight really does give us an edge for the engineering department. Engineers are incredible, and not all of them have the lighting experience, although we do have others that do it at Phillips Entertainment. It's an asset to be able to tell at the point of creating the software and so forth. We can tell immediately if something is going in the right direction. But it does speed up the process. And it also helps us design things that are more functional towards what the customers have expectations for the light.